make it for chain reaction is only 0.14%. So to make it economically feasible for our energy purposes, what we need, we have to enrich, and only few countries have the facilities for enrichment. So in modern reactors, enrichment factors of about 7 to 10 is used. But for atom bombs or for bombs like this, usually 80 to 90% enrichment is used. So we don't need to have an enrichment plant. Those countries are having or trying, they are in trouble. You know about Pakistan, about Iran, about North Korea. What is the problem with the world? Why the other world is going to attack them or going to have investigation into them? Because they are trying to enrich uranium. Okay. Although we don't know whether their intention to make bombs or something or for the peaceful uses, we don't know. But still, the world is afraid of them. Anyway, so what? How the chain reaction or what the chain reaction happens? How can we make it? We need a nuclear power reactor. It has the structure like this. So where the reaction occurs? The reaction occurs here. This is the reactor. The uranium fuel are being inserted here, and the control rods are there for controlling. And this is a prototype of pressurized reactor. What happens in the pressurized reactor? Chain reaction occurs here and produces tremendous heat. So, and it runs into a closed loop in contact with pure water, very, very pure water. So when the water gets heat, it will try to boil up. Okay. So what we do to increase its boiling point, what we do? We apply pressure. And so it absorbs more heat, and this heat is exchanged here in the steam generator, and it produces high quality steam, very dry, and the steam temperature is around 300 degrees Celsius. Okay, that means superheated steam, and it goes to this steam, heats a turbine which rotates the generator and produces electricity, and the steam is again condensed and recycled to the steam generator. So this is the simplest way what we can describe, but it is very, very, very complicated and requires high technology. And in future, you will do it, we hope. Although we have started, I don't know, I think particularly the engineering graduates of the future, they will have the responsibility to carry it over. Okay. Then why do we need it? So this is a picture of what? Reactors. These are the reactors. And these chimneys, what you say, these are the cooling towers. Okay? And those, the reactor buildings, there are two units. As you can see, this is a Russian built reactor. Next, I can do it. Then why do we need, we say that nuclear is a sustainable energy source. That means if we don't have sustainable energy source, what will happen to us, to the mankind? We are dependent in all respect on electricity or the power. So as the society grows, our amenities, our requirements grows, we need more electricity. So we must need non-renewable steel. It can sustain for a long time, because other energy sources, fossil fuels, having very adverse effects on the environment. It has limited reserve. Other sources, renewable energy, if you take solar energy, output is very low, particularly especially for Bangladesh. We have a small land area, but a very big population. For us, those are not technically feasible, that we can spend much money for production of so much electricity what we need. So this is a sustainable, the picture shows that there are so many reactors and so many cities, industries, everything is connected to it, and it can survive for a long time. Then next, energy security for future generation, for you. Say we have the gas reserves for how many years, do you know? We have started for last 10 years or something like that. But now we are thinking that we are almost exhausted and we cannot distribute it. So we must need something which is sustainable, and nuclear energy can provide it. So nuclear power can contribute to energy security by stably supplying fuel regardless of the global energy landscape. Uranium has the longest period of reserve production, production ratio, and is well spread around the world. You can see there is a comparison: oil, liquid natural gas, coal, and uranium. So oil has about 40 years reserve. Almost now you might be hearing about that. Even Saudi Arabia and United Arab Emirates, Iran, those who are very oil-rich countries, they are going to plant nuclear power reactors. And if you compare the reserves, you can have an idea why the world is going to be nuclear. In particularly in Asia, 21 countries are going with the nuclear power program, okay? Especially Bangladesh, Vietnam, and some other countries, Arabian countries, they are needing it, wanting. And the uranium, spread of the uranium deposits, or where uranium mines or resources are available, you can see it is scattered all over the world. Next slide. So appointed, okay. So nuclear power, a green energy source. This is very important. That means, what is the problem with the fossil fuels? That means we are using coal, oil, or natural gas. What is the problem? The problem is emission of carbon dioxide, that means greenhouse effect. And what happens to carbon dioxide? What is the percentage of carbon dioxide? Do you know in the air? 0.0. What is the percentage of oxygen? 21. What about nitrogen? So nobody is talking about nitrogen or oxygen, but everyone is talking about carbon dioxide. What's the problem with carbon dioxide? It produces greenhouse effect. How? Not destroying ozone. It's simply because the energy coming from the sun, okay, it initiates a vibration mode in carbon dioxide. It absorbs the sunlight and then immediately it releases it as heat energy. So this relaxation time is 10 to the power minus 8 seconds. So in 10 to the power 8 minus 8 seconds, it takes energy, releases heat. At the same, after elapse of 10 to the power minus 8 seconds, it again returns to its original mode and again takes energy. So there are, if one one mole of carbon dioxide contains about 6.03 into 10 to the power 23 number of carbon dioxide molecules. So, and billions of tons of carbon dioxide we are exposing in the environment. If these billions of tons of carbon dioxide takes small, even the smallest heat and releases it to the earth, what happens? It warms up and giving us the global warming and climate change, those who are evident in the lower picture. Okay, in the lower picture, what shows? What it shows? Ice breaking, sea rise level, and other environmental adverse effects. Okay, and if we go to compare the production of carbon dioxide from all the fuels, what happens? The nuclear is lowest. Okay, if we grade, the first one is coal, 991, almost 1000 is to 10. So to save us from the adverse environmental effects, we have to go nuclear. That's why the world is trying to not producing all the electricity from the nuclear, but an energy mix, say around 10%. What is written there? If there are no nuclear power, the world's total carbon dioxide emission would increase by 10%. Okay. And another advantage is stable supply of electricity. You can compare with 1 gram of uranium equivalent to 9 drams of oil and 3 tons of coal. See, if we can burn 1 gram of uranium 235, it is equivalent to 3 tons of coal. So much energy is inside the uranium. Okay. Next, it is a comparison of fuel cost benefits. That means you can see from the graphs that the energy production cost for oil, gas, and coal, nuclear is obviously stable and the lowest one. And if you go on the production cost, total production cost of electricity on the fuel cost, nuclear is the less sensitive, but oil is the highest. What happens now? In the world market, the price of oil increased too much, and so is the cost of electricity. In all countries, particularly in our countries, the government is making some subsidy. But in Europe, European countries, say for example Germany, has abandoned their nuclear electricity production after the Fukushima. What happens? Their electricity cost already 6 times now. So what they are doing, Czechoslovakia is a small country, but they have 2 nuclear reactors and they have some excess electricity. They are buying electricity from Germany. Before that, Germany would sell electricity to other countries. So the reverse is coming. Particularly for Bangladesh, if we go think in long run for the future generation, we must have a mixture of electricity from the nuclear power. That's why I want to share the idea and the necessity to you all. And disadvantages. Before that, I'm saying that sometimes back, in say 10 years back or even 15 years back, the oil businessmen producing oil, those who are connected with the oil business, they used to display big posters saying that the electricity coming from a nuclear power plant is also radioactive. Do you understand what I say? So their propaganda was like that, the electricity coming from the nuclear power plant is also radioactive. Okay, but now, particularly in New York or America, But now they don't dare to say something like it because this is the necessity. Nuclear obviously has disadvantages of radiation and other human have safety concerns and other things. But still, the place where they used to display big posters and rallies against the nuclear power plant, now they are gathering in rallies in favor of the nuclear, save the world. Okay, the situation has come like this. So what are the disadvantages? This we have so concerned, we have to also take into consideration about this. High initial investment for a nuclear power plant, say about $5 to $8 billion for 1,000 megawatt. But after long run, the cost becomes the lowest. If you take the futuristic view or the overall consideration, and strict safety and security measures for nuclear power plant, although say some countries say it is for the terrorist attack or other things, or natural calamities, you must have very, very strict safety and security measures if you are going to have one nuclear power plant. Waste and spent fuel preservation or disposal, this is also involves big money. But the technology is advancing so that the nuclear power plants make smaller waste and take smaller amount of money for that. High tech involvement, because everything you have to control from remote areas or have to be automated, so it needs the technology at each standard. And I think the future engineers, future scientists of Bangladesh, they will take up this matter for their own. Okay, protection from natural disaster like earthquake, flood, tsunami. Although it is said, particularly after Fukushima, that accident, that we have to have new safety standards or safety regulations like that. Actually, what happened with the Fukushima? Fukushima is a different type of reactor. What we shown here is a pressurized water reactor, and Fukushima was boiling water reactors. And at that time, the Fukushima plant was built in 1960s. So at that time, this tsunami level was not expected to be so much higher. And also the safety measures were some relaxed. And also from my personal view, as I passed long time in Japan, they give more emphasis on money rather than safety of the people and like that. I have seen, although it is not for criticism, but as a nation, some nations are very crazy for profits, okay? So the power plants owners or public entrepreneurs, they need profits. What I know about the Fukushima, one of the plants which undergone a minor accident, that the one of the pipes in the cooling circuit were damaged, and the government personnel, they said that it must be repaired immediately within a week. But for 6 months, they are going with that, replacing that. Because these pipes are very high-grade steel and very costly one. But a big company like TAPCO, they could change it. Somehow, they wanted more profit with the same one, so the accident happened. So this also have to be taken in consideration. And public acceptance and political decision. This is very, very important. And it is also task of the young people to motivate the public, because they have some misconceptions as well as fears that we don't have to be afraid of somehow. So now we are going about Bangladesh perspective, what we are doing, what we have to see in the future. And this is the Rupur nuclear power plant, okay? And this is the, what you say, this residential area. It was built in 1962 or 63, like that. But still, we had this old picture. Now, our country, well, you know all this data for Bangladesh, but one thing what I highlighted is the population density is 1,080 per persons per square kilometer, and it is the highest in the world. So for these small countries with very high population density, the energy selection of the energy source is very, very important. So we have many power plants now based on oil and natural gases. The space they occupy, the people needed for their maintenance, the raw materials they consume. If you make it more compact, more precise, and more output, then it would be more convenient for us, for countries like this. Electric power situation in Bangladesh, we have to consider it. As you know, it is the data is June 2014, estimate of June 2014, installed generation capacity for electricity generation. That means the capacity, the installations we do have, the thermal plants, the hydroelectric and everything, it is 10,241 megawatts. This is the capacity, but not actual production. So if we categorize those capacity, 2.44% based on coal, 64.59% on gas, 19.17% high furnace oil, and high speed diesel 6.67%, hydro 2.25%, imported 4.88%. So which one is, one of these is the most environment friendly? Which one?
Yes.
No. Hydro is the most environmental friendly, but unfortunately our country is a plain one. We don't have much resources for hydroelectric power. Only one Kaptai, we can use it. And maximum generation capacity is 7,356 megawatts. And our plan about the future, what the government plan, outline perspective plan according to our 2010 to 2021. This is the perspective plan that we conceive. That means we visualize. Is according to our vision 2021. Well, the first goal is digital Bangladesh. Second is electricity for all. But if you cannot have some other sources, economical as well as productive sources for electricity generation, you cannot achieve that one, that electricity for all. Targets of electricity generation as per OPP is written here. That means we have a very big ask, very big ask for future and look for future. So we need more generation capacity. So the nuclear power plant status that we are aiming at, actually it was taken, the project was taken by the then Pakistan government in early 60s, that they would build a nuclear power plant at Trupur of Pabna district in Bangladesh, okay? And Rupur power nuclear power plant site was selected in 1963. So what happened, the Pakistan, it was a central government project, and they allocated budgets and everything they made. But when the political unrest in the then East Pakistan came to existence, that means we are defying the Pakistan government, then they were thinking another thing. If we give low cost electricity to these Bengali people, one day they will be separated. So what are our benefits? So they change this project, they freeze the budget and transfer it to a project in Karachi. Okay? And till then, this big land have been lying vacant. But by this time, this government, the Bangladesh government, the governments in Bangladesh, time to time took many, many attempts, but was not successful because of the world politics, not the internal one. Okay, some countries offered to give a plan, some other tried to tackle it. Still, it is going on, but now I think the people as well as the government and all the political parties are determined to go on with the nuclear power project. So at that time, it was a 260-acre land, and now it has expanded a little bit and is large enough for accommodating two more power units. Okay, a number of feasibility studies were conducted, and each of these established the technical, financial and economic feasibility of two nuclear power project. That means this feasibility study primary was done, and this is the picture which shows that we had an agreement. It is called intergovernment agreement, and this kind of agreement are usually very, very valuable. That means two governments are bound to complete the task, and this is called intergovernment, and it was signed on 2nd November 2011. So in the picture you can see our Prime Minister as well as the Minister, State Minister for Science and Technology, and the Russian is the chairman of Rosatom, that is the company or the government company for the Russian atomic energy. But he was the Prime Minister of Russia for few days. Okay, so he is a very high placed dignitary. Anyway, these are not important for you for your knowledge, but just for information. That means the contract which you signed with the Russian, what are inside? Okay, that is, there are some points that we cannot do by ourselves. For example, fuel, spent fuel management and other things. So these are in these contracts. Somehow we say that we can proceed with that, those conditions, what the Russians gave and we gave. Okay. And this is also some dates, the other things which we have signed with the Russians. Okay. Particularly one thing important, those who are interested, is the third para, a public information center on nuclear energy located at the premises of Bangabandhu Novo Theater by the Russian Federation. It started working from 1st October 2013, and they have some very beautiful displays about the nuclear power plants, nuclear energy, and Russian made videos and some other displays you can visit sometimes. Any of you have visited those, that center? I think not yet. It is not publicized so much. So, and then this is what we signed with the Russian, three contracts, all about the preparatory stage of the nuclear power plant. And it is scheduled to be completed by 2016. After that, the actual plant construction will start. Then the Prime Minister of Bangladesh inaugurated the first phase of construction works on October 2013, and this is the ceremonial inauguration you can see. And next, this is the contents what the from the young engineers and scientists we need. Nuclear power plant, a mega project and a big ask. That means, what are the things inside? Huge initial investment and multi-phase implementation. It takes around 5 to 8 years for the construction. Okay, and our plant, we expecting it will provide at least 1,000 megawatt of electricity by 2021, but we are not sure, but it is our target. Okay, then multi-dimensional management. The management of a nuclear power plant is very, very complicated as a multi-dimensional, because it has to consider the engineering works, the scientific works, the financial, everything. So it is the management is huge, procurement and many, many other things, and all specialized, not usually applicable to ordinary commodities or something like that. And national, international regulation and standards. This is very important, because rich countries don't want that poor countries have nuclear power. Also, they have also fear of terrorism, and they have this sort of mania, particularly for Bangladesh and some other countries in Asia. So we have to follow many, many international regulations and as well as standards. Standard means regulations. If you say that you can prepare, you can manufacture a writing pen, okay, but it has to be, you must have this standard, then you are gone. Because what the standard said by the United States, you cannot sell it in Bangladesh. As is happening in our EPZs, okay, they have the standard of their own, that is standard of the European markets. So if you have to pay for those products, you have to pay by the European standards. Our, we cannot afford it. Okay, this is one kind of regulations or barrier like this. Anyway, we have these problems, strict quality measures, and this is compulsory, not for the sake of us or them, it is for the sake of everyone. That means everywhere, everything in the nuclear power plant must have a certain quality to avoid the accidents or safety measures, etc. And long implementation time, as I said, advanced technology involvement. That means that technology is very skilled manpower. I have given a list: scientific, physical, geological, biosciences, many disciplines there, engineering, civil, mechanical, electrical, electronics, architect, everyone is involved. But the main task is on mechanical. Because as you see in the plant, all heat transfer phenomenon, hydraulics and generator, many things, and these are, but others also contribute, chemical, metallurgical. If we design or make a plant, but not for us, what we are taking from Russia is contract, the turnkey. That means they will make it everything for us, just they will hand over the operation to us after 5 years after the construction. But by this time, we have to make our personnel, engineers and technical personnel, trained up to the level that they can operate with the everything. And every aspect has a very, very big dimension. Only if you can think that connecting the power output from the nuclear power plant to national grid is a huge, huge task. So every, from the start to finish, it has a very big ask, okay? Technicians and operators, highest safety and security measures. So this is also, you have to think, you have a big cost on the production, big arrangement for the personnel, for the instruments, and for everything. Infrastructure for transportation and communication. So our infrastructure, do you know Rupur, where it is? In Ishwardi, right, exactly. So the components which have to be brought up from Russia to the site of Pabna, our present infrastructure for the road communication and the riverine or the water waterways is not up to the standard. We have to upgrade those so that they can carry, they can take the loads, what the components will come in future. Infrastructures and transportation communication and involvement of local engineers, farms, contractors, entrepreneurs, suppliers, many things. If about the entrepreneurs, about the local farms or engineering farms, when they can participate, if they can satisfy the standards needed for nuclear. So everywhere, when you thinking about the materials used in the reactor, everything, you have to have nuclear grade materials, nuclear grade personnel, nuclear grade techniques, everything. So this is also a need for company formation. Still the operator, operating agency is Bangladesh Atomic Energy Commission, but Bangladesh Atomic Energy Commission cannot complete a nuclear power project. You have to have a big company having all the personnel assembled, all the management system, all technical systems, then you can implement those things. And many others also requirements. So it is on the shoulder of the future generation that some of them will take up and will think about the NPP from now, and when they get matured, they will take up the responsibility. Global trends, and this is a very unfortunate scene. What you can see is a nuclear power plant built by the Americans, Westinghouse, very famous one, in Philippines. But what happens? They completed everything. So the political decision was given by Aquino, you know, the Filipino leader, very popular one, Corazon Aquino, her government. So at that time they made everything, but when they went to insert the fuel rod into the reactor, that means they will start up. So the three local MPs say that no, we are not going nuclear anyway. Then everything turned, and it is now an exhibition site. Yes, of course, I visited that plant. How strongly it was built. But unfortunately, billions of dollars lying rest, okay? So what is the global trend? If we see this pie chart and the graph, what we see, what is the share of the nuclear power in the world? According to 2010, it was 13.4% for the nuclear, coal 40.8%, and others, gas 21.3%, and like this. But those sources, except hydro, all others now are poison for us if we think about the environment and our existence as well. So the current target is to increase nuclear from 13.4% to around 20%, so that there is a balance between the emission of carbon dioxide and the global temperature. Okay. And the next one is the share of electricity production by nuclear power plants. And you can see up to 2010, it was increasing. After that, 11, 12, there is a fall. Why? Because of the Fukushima accident. Because particularly Japan and Germany, they abandoned their plant. But Japan, what are they doing? they reverted to nuclear power. Okay, the present government takes strict decision that we go back to nuclear. But if you think one thing, that the Japan was the first victim of nuclear bombs, but they adopted the nuclear reactor technology for their electricity production, and their share of electricity production is over 30%, say around about 38%. So when they abandoned that nuclear power plant, or they ordered the shutdown, not abandoned, shutdown, they had the problem for their electricity production price. So they now again reverted, but with the restriction that everything should be checked again, safety standard, new safety standard should be in place, and new plant must have the safety standard so that it can withstand the tsunami. Actually, in Fukushima, what happened? Do you know? When the earthquake happened, it could make no damage to the nuclear power plant. But when the tsunami came, it washed out the emergency power supply and it shut down the cooling circuit. That's why it happened. But now if we take considerable safety measures, this cannot happen. Next, why it's not working? I have to go here. This is the number of reactors in operation worldwide. To which country stops? Yes, it has a greater share, but it asks us not to do it. Okay, anyway, now, this is the picture for 2007. By this time, many new countries entered into the nuclear arena, and the chart might be different. So future consideration, what our thought about the future, and the background is a, what is that? Yes, it's a picture of reactor, but a different kind of reactor called molten salt reactor, okay? So now the world is thinking and doing rigorous research on these two systems for better safety, less fear, more economy, more electricity production. And one is molten salt fission reactor based on lithium, beryllium, uranium fluoride fuel and lithium, beryllium, fluoride coolant. Now the fuel is solid fuel, but this is the liquid molten salt. And it has the advantage, or the technology had been advanced, that if there is an accident, what will happen? This molten salt will go downwards. If we go to the previous one, these are the reservoirs, so that the molten fuel as well as everything and the coolant can go underground. And immediately, because the solid has higher cooling rate than the liquid, it cools, solidifies immediately and cools down. So there will be no melting, further melting, no explosion. So this technology is advancing, not only advancing, we expect that it will produce commercial power plant in 20 to 30 years. And advantages are much more safer than water cooled fission reactors, less radioactive waste, safer shutdown and auto containment of the molten core, less fuel cost. Commercial plants are expected in 20 to 30 years. So this is the advantage, and in future we are going to have this molten salt type reactors like this. And fusion reactor, unfortunately, there has been much money spent on this technology, but still there are some problems which are difficult to surmount. But we are hopeful about that fusion will bring about some commercial plants, and not near future, but in long future run anyway. Then the concluding remarks. Production of electricity using nuclear energy has become an urgent necessity and a big challenge for Bangladesh. The topic is going to be one of the most important global issue in the 21st century because of the dreadful environmental effects of the traditional fuel usage. It is very important to ensure energy security for future generation of Bangladesh and needs special attention of the young scientists, engineers, and technologists. Application of nuclear energy bears two opposite aspects. One is peaceful purpose and destructive purpose. So we must go for the peaceful purpose. And in fact, in the world, the destructive one have subsided, because after the Hiroshima, the world became so afraid. Although there are so many nuclear weapons already, I think it is at least 10,000 times more than what the world had at the Hiroshima time, but no use of one single one because of this. Only we want to get others afraid of something like this. In spite of occasional accidents and fear of destructive use, the technology is under development for making safe an energy source for sustainable growth for mankind. Because without energy, mankind cannot sustain. So before giving you thanks, I have some other things if someone comes and help me. Just very short video clips about the technologies. Okay. Not that one. No, no, no. This left. So three video clips. First one, not this one, the first. I think this is okay. This first, please play it. What we can see, I can, and we can think about this. Okay, anyway, I think you have already got an idea. No need for further. So what is that video shows? Fission reaction. That's one neutron hitting another one, and it gives two, three, then more. So this is the chain reaction. Okay, that means whenever it hits, you say flash of light. What it means? Yes, it releases tremendous energy, and this is we use in the reactor. Second one, please. How nuclear reactors? Okay.
Nuclear power plants are thermal power stations which generate electrical energy from heat. They consist of numerous buildings and facilities, the most important of which are as follows. The turbine building houses several turbines as well as the generator necessary for electrical power generation. The containment building where the nuclear reactor is housed is made of meter-thick reinforced concrete. Inside this building, nuclear reactions take place where water is heated up. The cooling tower, which can be as tall as 200 meters, is where hot water is cooled. In order to easily understand the underlying principles, the following is a description of the most important components of a nuclear power plant that uses a pressurized water reactor, PWR. In the reactor pressure vessel, the nuclear reaction and the associated release of thermal energy takes place. In a pressurized water reactor, as in this case, the reactor pressure vessel stands about 12 meters tall. The walls are about 25 centimeters thick. Inside is where the fuel assemblies can be found. In pressurized water reactors, about 150 such assemblies are installed. A single fuel assembly is composed of many fuel rods. A fuel rod is about 5 meters in length and has a diameter of about 23 centimeters. The actual nuclear fuel is found inside of each fuel rod. Small nuclear fuel pellets composed of enriched uranium or plutonium make nuclear fission chain reaction possible. In the fission chain reaction, thermal energy is released. Water is needed in order to absorb the thermal energy and keep the chain reaction going. Inside the vessel, the water is heated to over 570 degrees Fahrenheit. The water does not boil, however, since the pressurizer maintains the water pressure constant at around 160 bars. The heated water is eventually pumped to a heat exchanger, also called steam generator. These are typically in the form of a shell and tube heat exchanger. Hot water flows through the U-tubes, heating up the metal of the pipes so that any water inside the heat exchanger begins to boil. Eventually fed through a set of pipes to the turbine building. The steam first drives a high-pressure turbine and then is typically fed to two low-pressure turbines. All of the turbines are connected by a spinning shaft to the electrical generator, which in turn produces AC electricity from the shaft's rotational energy. The steam is converted again into liquid form in a condenser, and then returned back to the steam generator. The water needed for this often comes from an adjacent river or is cooled in a cooling tower. The water circulation systems are always kept separate from one another. Water in the primary circulation system never leaves the containment building. This water is radioactive since it has been in direct contact with the fuel rods. Water in the secondary circulation system is used to drive the turbines and is not radioactive. The cooling circulation system provides cooling water and is used to condense the steam in the secondary circulation system.
Okay, and the third one, it is about, about 60 years of nuclear energy. That means for last 60 years is a Russian made video. You can see many in the internet.
Thank you.
So I think you have seen the past as well as the future of the nuclear energy. So I can thank you all for your patience. Okay. Thank you. And if you have small questions or something. আমাদের সরকারের বা আমাদের নাই এখন আপাতত, তাই না? $5 billion বা $8 billion একসাথে দিতে হচ্ছে না। সো উই মেড এগ্রিমেন্ট উইথ রাশিয়া, দে উইল মেক অল ফাইন্যান্সেস বাট দে উইল টেক দি প্রফিট ইন্টারেস্ট। ওকে, দিস ইজ এ কম্পিটিটিভ ওয়ার্ল্ড। ওকে, অফ কোর্স রাশিয়া মেড রিঅ্যাক্টরস স্টিল দি চিপেস্ট। ইফ ইউ টেক আমেরিকান ওয়ান, ইট উইল হ্যাভ বেটার সেফটি ফিচার্স অর সাম লং ডিউরেবিলিটি এটসেট্রা। বাট রাশিয়ান রিঅ্যাক্টরস অলসো নাও ইন অপারেশন সে 50 years, 60 years লাইক দিস। অ্যান্ড হোয়াট দ্য চেরনোবিল, ওকে, দিস ইজ দ্য মোস্ট উইক পয়েন্ট অবাউট দ্য রাশিয়ান রিঅ্যাক্টরস। বাট অ্যাকচুয়ালি দিস হ্যাপেন্ড নট ডিউ টু এরর অর সামথিং, বাট দে বিকজ দে ওয়ান্টেড টু ডু সামথিং ইন দ্য রিঅ্যাক্টর হুইচ ইজ নট ইন্টারন্যাশনাল অ্যালাউড। ওকে, দে ওয়ান্ট টু মেক সাম অ্যাম্বিশিয়াস এক্সপেরিমেন্টস, এ গ্রুপ অফ সায়েন্টিস্ট এট দ্যাট টাইম। অ্যান্ড the Russians were so sanguine about their reactors, they did not have confinement building, they had only the reactor building. Had they placed the confinement building, the destruction was not expected so much. Okay, was not happened. So this is a that's why if you plan to have a nuclear reactor, you have to make the financial things first. Yes, of course, you are obviously okay, because since they are the sole responder to Bangladesh appeal, when Bangladesh was making tender for that, the only responder to this, so they will make some monopoly, no doubt. It is an open secret. Okay, but still, for the country, particularly if you think about the increasing population, okay, we have to make our power plants concise with greater outputs. This is the strategy. Okay, say one in Rupur, say 2000 megawatt, now we are trying for that. If we can make on the south a sea water cooling water based one, say around 3000 megawatt, something like that, then we are at least will have satisfaction that in 2020 we don't have to go for load shedding for 60 hours or 70 hours a week like that. So this is the idea. Okay, and in future I think the second or third one, there will be an involvement, knowledgeable person from Bangladesh. Now the problem, please, it's a secret, don't be so. That's the thing, that actually we cannot judge because we don't have enough manpower to judge for the procurement. Okay, if the Russians say that this is $5, I cannot say that no, it is sold in $3, because until and unless a company, a foreign company, competes in nuclear matters, no one discloses price. So we don't know the actual price of the components or the things like that. So for the first reactor, it happens for all countries, not for us. Although the Korea now one of the richest in nuclear power, they want to sell electricity to many other countries. They're having surplus and they are growing in industry. their history is more serious. That what they had to do depend on when they started. But still we are in the more developed country and more well communicated country, the world. That means we have access to many information now. But before that it was not like that. They started in 1970s, 1960s like this. Okay. So this is the thing. Yes.
I'm quite
Yes. ইয়াংদের কাছ থেকে এই ধরনের প্রশ্ন আসা আর কি। প্রথম এটা ছিল যে কি পানির প্রবাহ না আচ্ছা বিবিআর 1000 তাই না? হ্যাঁ, এটা হলো যে বিবিআর 1000 ডিজাইন বা মডেল বলা হচ্ছে, কিন্তু এর ডিজাইন তো এখনো হয়নি। ডিজাইনটা হবে যে আফটার অল দি ইনিশিয়াল ওয়ার্কস, পার্টিকুলারলি সয়েল কন্ডিশন, সয়েল জিওলজিক্যাল সার্ভে, ইঞ্জিনিয়ারিং সার্ভে, এনভায়রনমেন্টাল সার্ভে, এভরিথিং হওয়ার পরে দেন ইট উইল প্লেস। আর বিবিআর কারো কাছ 1000 বিক্রি করতে পারেনি এই কথাটা আমাদের সংবাদপত্রে যদি আসে তাহলে ভুল, কারণ রাশিয়াতে অলরেডি বিবিআর বেশ কিছু ইনস্টল আছে, বিবিআর ভিয়েতনামে করা হচ্ছে তাই না? এবং এবং যেই মডেলে হবে হোক, যেটাই হবে হোক, অলওয়েজ সেফটি ফিচার্স আর আপগ্রেডেড, হ্যাঁ, উইথ দ্যাট এক্সপেন্ড টাইম। যেমন জাপানের কথা আমি বলছি যে জাস্ট এটা আমি একটা ইয়ে দিয়েছি জাপান, কিন্তু এখন যে জাপান যে সমস্ত পাওয়ার প্ল্যান্ট তৈরি করতে যাচ্ছে ওগুলোর সেফটি এবং সিকিউরিটি ফিচার সো টাইট, সো মাচ, নাথিং ক্যান ইম্পিড। কারণ ওদের একটা ইনসিডেন্ট হয়েছিল ডিউরিং ফুকুশিমা অ্যাক্সিডেন্ট, হঠাৎ কী হয়েছে যে যখন অ্যাক্সিডেন্ট হয়েছে সাংবাদিকরা গাড়ি নিয়ে ভিতরে ঢুকে পড়েছে এবং এটা ওরা ট্রেসপাসিংয়ের পর্যায়ে ধরেছে, যদিও তারা নিয়েছিল জাস্ট টু কালেক্ট নিউজ। ওকে, সো this world is becoming more cautious about those things. And tarpor holo panir flow, tai na? Panir flow really jokhon prothom kora hoyechilo tokhon etar maximum ya kora hoyechilo 300 megawatt. Okay. পরে 600 মেগাওয়াট পর্যন্ত ফিজিবিলিটি স্টাডি করা হয়েছে, এরপর করা হয়নি। কিন্তু রাশিয়ানরা বলছে যে না, বলছে না, এখন ওয়ার্ল্ডে প্র্যাকটিস হচ্ছে, সেটা হলো যে কুলিং টাওয়ার, সে ইনস্টিড অফ ওয়ান কুলিং টাওয়ার উইল হ্যাভ ল মেনি রিজার্ভার্স, প্যাসিভ রিজার্ভার্স অ্যাজ ওয়েল অ্যাজ অ্যাক্টিভ ওয়ান্স, ওকে, দোজ উইল রিজার্ভ ওয়াটার ফর লং টাইম and then we use for the cooling purpose. This is the idea here. Another idea is that we can excavate a feeder canal from Jamuna, okay, and feed to the power plant with the flow of Padma, what we are flowing there. These two ideas, yes, this will increase the cost more. And second thing is that what you said, that whether the price is inclusive or not, okay. এই প্রাইসটা হলো অ্যাকচুয়ালি নিউক্লিয়ার পাওয়ার প্ল্যান্টের ফুয়েল কস্ট ইজ ভেরি ভেরি ফুয়েল কস্ট ইজ ভেরি লো, বাট দ্য মেইন কস্ট ইজ দ্য কনস্ট্রাকশন অ্যান্ড ট্রান্সপোর্টেশন, বিকজ ইট ইজ দ্য টার্কি বেসিস, দ্য ফার্স্ট টাইম হোয়েন এভার উই উইল হ্যাভ এভরিথিং ইন প্লেস, জাস্ট ইউ পুশ দ্য কি অ্যান্ড ইউ রান দ্য রিয়েক্টর, অ্যান্ড দে হ্যাভ দ্য কন্ট্রাক্ট দ্যাট দে উইল বি রেসপন্সিবল ফর অপারেশন ফর 5 years, দেন দে উইল hand over to us, to our engineers, our scientists for operation. So this is the about the pricing. And then what? Spent fuel they will take. Then what they will do after reprocessing, it is yet not known. This will be done by that. But other remaining waste, we have depository and we will excavate the depository for that. And there will be no high level radioactive materials here in Bangladesh. This is the plan. And then? সেফটি, হ্যাঁ সেফটি, হ্যাঁ অফকোর্স নিরাপত্তা, সেফটি নট সিকিউরিটি, সে লোকাল পিপল অ্যান্ড আদার সেফটি ফিচার্স, আমাদের ইলেকট্রিসিটি কস্ট ডে বাই ডে যেভাবে বাড়ছে, তাই না, সেই হিসাবে নিউক্লিয়ার সেফটি ফিচারের জন্য একবার খরচ করতে হবে, কিন্তু তেল আমদানি করে আমি ইলেকট্রিসিটি প্রোডাকশন করলে প্রতি বছরে বাড়বে, বিকজ আওয়ার গ্যাস রিজার্ভ ইজ গোয়িং টু অ্যাডজাস্ট ইন ফিউ ইয়ার্স টাইম, সো ইফ ইউ থিঙ্ক ইন দ্য লং রান, হোয়াই আই ডোন্ট ইনভেস্ট লং হিউজ ইনভেস্টমেন্ট, মেক ইনভেস্টমেন্ট সিঙ্গল টাইম ফর 50 to 60 years, অর আই এম পেয়িং এভরি ইয়ার হায়ার অ্যান্ড হায়ার প্রাইস, সো দেয়ার ইজ অপশন, দ্য গভর্নমেন্ট হ্যাজ টেকেন দিস অপশন. অ্যান্ড অ্যাবাউট দ্য নিউজ পেপার্স, প্লিজ ডোন্ট টেক এভরিথিং সিরিয়াসলি. ডিউরিং আওয়ার, I think you belong to the group of journalists, do you? No. Then we are safe to say. So for the journalists, I can say that during the IGA, intergovernment agreement signature, they were present, they appreciated, they made questions, and they were entertained for everything, and they were committed to write positive to that power plant, and they were convinced at that time, particularly the Russian side as well as our side, but they kept silent. At that time I was in charge of the scientific information division dealing with these reporters and things like that. They were so much cordial, and they were committed to write at least some positive features of that, but they kept silent for 2 weeks. After 2 weeks, they are writing against it. So they are always, for the nuclear matters, not in our country, for every country, there is one group, those who are involved with the oil business, okay, they are always ready with some money to write against that, okay. And some people, activists were there, but now they kept silent. You cannot see for recent months Greenpeace activity against nuclear for the last few months or few years. But before that, even if some ships were carrying some nuclear medicine materials, you know how many billions of people are served every year with the nuclear medicine? In our country, every government hospital has a nuclear medicine center. And we have thousands of patients every week for treatment, for diagnostic purposes, for the nuclear medicine. But still, some ships carrying radioactive materials for nuclear medicine purpose, there was a Greenpeace ship throwing stones to the other ship. That is destroying. But now, for last few months or few years, you cannot see these activities like this. Somehow, in conclusion, I must say that we have to find sources, long-lasting, sustainable sources, and with greater output for our country. Especially small countries having small land area but bigger population. So we have to sacrifice somewhere, this way or that way. If you want constant electricity flow in your house, then you have to sacrifice something else. That's the thing, and we have to take risks. So this is the final thing. And incidentally, we are planning to have another one, better one, in the northern part of the country. And this is also a necessity for us. So you are satisfied with your answers? Projukti, about the technology, I think is about 70% propaganda, and 30% is truth. If boiling water reactor in Japan could withstand for 60 years until the tsunami came, why not BBR 1000 sustained for 50 years in Bangladesh? I don't have any meaning. Because when you go to write against something, you can write many things. Make me a thief within 5 seconds if you just go to some newspaper and say that these people has committed a great theft. If you can write, people will see lakhs of people. So one time it is established, like Hitler. You know about the propaganda of Hitler? Yes, I say that 70% is propaganda, 30% is truth. Russians, still they are lagging behind, say, France and European reactors. But it is not like that everyone will burst into a big explosion in 1 second, like that, no? Some other things may also happen, like, say, Japan. They are very sanguine and confident about their electricity production. But suddenly, the tsunami came. Nobody was expecting. So anything can happen anywhere in the world. So, okay, thank you. Any others? So, Achar, Jana, if you want to know about the views and ideas, I think the best is the net web. You have many logics in favor, against it. I think for the recent years or recent months or coming years, coming months and the coming world, you will see more in favor, but upgrading the technology. So thank you again. Thanks for listening.